peaceful protest with the entire political party, students' organizations, civil society organizations, and NGOs has called this indefinite call all over Tripura. And the reaction is that we don't want this CIP to be passed, and we don't want this camp to be placed in the Rajya Sabha. Therefore, we request and we urge the government of India to withdraw and cancel this bill. Because if the bill is passed, then how the Indian government is going to tackle the illegal influx migration? Because by today, we already noticed that in Tripura, the indigenous people has become officially, of course, it is 31, but unofficially, we could see we are less than 20%. So therefore, in order to give justice and protection of the indigenous people and to protect the social, cultural, economic and political right, the government of India should consider and withdraw this bill. Therefore, in every corner of Tripura and in every district of Tripura, the picketers are there peacefully protesting, asking the government of India to withdraw. And we are also urging the state government to send this message to the central government and feel the pain of the indigenous people, and ask the state government is the owner and the parent of the state government, through the Honorable Chief Minister, should send a message to the central government that the people of Tripura doesn't want CAP to be passed. Because we have seen how the demography have changed, and the Chief Minister himself was present when we have talked with the Honorable Home Minister Amit Shah, that we have addressed the same issue and the same concerns, that we have become microscopy. Therefore, in order to protect the identity and the culture and the political right and economics of the indigenous people, the bill should not be passed. And if this bill passed, then there will be no protection and the indigenous people will be more marginalized and their identity will be lost. Therefore, the reaction is nothing but we are protesting against the rights that the Constitution has enshrined us. The right to assemble and freedom and expression is we are exercising. So when we exercise this, I think the government of India and the state government should respect the right of the people and take this, the voice of the indigenous people, to consider and withdraw the citizenship amendment.
Mention of the rule of police.
The rule of police are of course also respected, and we are happy with the kind of cooperation with the police that they are accepting with us. But nevertheless, we have seen when our people were trying to protest in the road, the two buses was detained. So most of the leaders and the students and the women were detained, and they were taken to the police station.
How many organizations joined in your movement?
This is the entire organization of the Tripura, including all the regional political parties and the students organization, as I have mentioned. There is no organization left, there is no individual left, but we all collectively stand together for opposing this citizenship amendment.